Hey guys, it's a tremendous honor to be kicking this off in Philly. We're a Philly region startup. We're actually from Delaware. And first time I came to Philly Tech Meetup, I felt like I had come into an oasis of community. So I'm really, really excited to be talking with you about the space of education and what it means to be a disruptive technology in it. How many people right now get calls from their university asking for money? How many of you people find that tremendously compelling when they do? Right? It's broken. 90% of alumni do not give to their universities. And yet, when it comes down to it, education requires all of us as a community to come together to make it happen. The 800-pound gorilla in innovation and education is one thing and one thing only. It's getting administrators and educators on the same side of the table. Once administrators understand the value of driving innovation in the classroom and get behind it, a lot of really cool things can happen. Right now, faculty have to fight the bureaucracy to bring innovation to the classroom. We're a game changer for that. We make it possible for them to bring it in. So I'll show you how that works. With USEED, we are kind of a donor's choose for a university. So in simple terms, we show them all kinds of different student projects, whether it's a non-for-profit cause, a restaurant that they want to open, a study that they want to do. This is undergraduate research on the psychology of trading behavior. A lot of people are geeking out on that one. And what's great about this is many of these students haven't quite gotten to the level yet where they could go on Kickstarter or Indiegogo, where they could go out and professionally crowdfund their project, if you will. But they're on to something. They're interested in something. They need education. And so what we do is we put their project up on the university's website, branded by the university. The university is blasting this out and give everyone an opportunity to participate in helping them. The big problem in crowdfunding for a university is that 501c3 regulations say you can't give money to a student in the name of a nonprofit and be a tax-deductible donation. So our whole game mechanic is about making that happen. When you make a gift, you're actually making it to a program, and the program in turn buys things that help the student project out. So unfortunately, you can't see the video, but this particular class project is a student startup who's getting branded by the university's communications class. So cool. They threw out the textbook. They got together as an entire class, and their project for this semester is to brand a startup. So the money you donate goes to helping to make that startup successful. We also added a gamification layer with sharing on Facebook and connecting on LinkedIn. So every time someone takes one of those actions, say you share it on your Facebook and you help this classroom win some fans and win some people who are going to support them, the student project gets points. And we use those points to reward them with all kinds of sponsorships, like pizza parties. Hipmunk is talking with us about giving away free trips. American Express wants to show them out on open forum. So it looks like my internet connection is just not going to survive here, but that's part of a beta display. I want to get to questions. So I'm just going to, you know, hopefully this will pop up in a second, but the second thing we do is we integrate with LinkedIn. If a student can find people in their professional network who will participate with them in these projects, the chances of them getting a job in that industry are much higher. So, you know, in this case, my fave, it's my favorite project. Sharing it on Facebook gives the students points, but we also give people the ability to connect with them through a LinkedIn group. So when you go to give them advice, you're actually giving them advice on a LinkedIn group, helping them build their professional network, and helping them answer the questions that they have. So I'm going to let the white screen talk from here. Any questions? How many students wish they had this when they were in school? Right. We're a Gen Y company. We see students who want to do a lot of different things, and schools keep trying to put them in boxes. Project-based learning sets that creativity free. Right. So yeah, the idea here was donation was what we started with. We raised several thousand dollars the first time we did it. And then we started hearing from people, yeah, but I'd love to mentor, I'd love to give advice. So that was where we started putting people together on LinkedIn. But the next thing we were going to do is actually add kind of a resource request, where, for instance, you know, someone who's studying nanotechnology can say, hey, I need a carbine laser with this exact millimeter. Anyone out there got that in their lab equipment and will loan it to me for an hour. So, you know, things like that, because we think the social sourcing is really where things are at. Right, so our revenue model, which was validated at the University of Delaware, was to charge an annual licensing fee, and that's for the value of enhancing the education, and then we take a per transaction fee like any crowdfunding platform does, and then of course pulling together sponsorship deals works. I should say, we are 2 months old, and in 6 weeks, we have 20 universities who want to use us, including Drexel, Temple, and a bunch of other top entrepreneurship programs. So, you know, I think people are afraid of getting into education technology because they see educational institutions as very bureaucratic. But what they forget is there are people in there who are very frustrated about the problem that they know needs to be solved. I'm not going to mention his name, but a local university faculty director said, you know, higher education is a bubble. This is the cure. This is how you cure it. This is how you make sure that students find their way to a career that they're passionate about and with people who will help them, you know, make it in their journey in life. Sure, you know, this isn't a walled garden here. The universities are using their fundraising marketing budget to market these projects to their alumni. But of course, this is open to the whole community. Students can invite their family and friends. Faculty actually, on a pretty regular basis, pimp out these projects just because they think they're cool. And so I think that that's part of the idea here, right? Bring the whole community together in an organic way. When a university wants to raise money from a new donor, for every $100 they get, how much do you think it costs them? Take a wild guess, just in your head, $25, $50, $75 to raise that $100. The answer is that they lose $125. They're pretty interested in finding another way of reaching donors. So we launched this like yesterday. So discussions, of course, haven't quite happened on all of the student project pages. But here you go. We're building this application layer on top of LinkedIn. We actually have a scientist from Zynga who's helping us build the game dynamics on the back end. And we like to think of ourselves as the Zynga of Facebook. We're creating this level, we're creating this gamification layer of like, help students out, help them network, help them find their way in life. And it makes LinkedIn kind of fun. Overhead? No, they're not. In fact, you know, so the idea here is eliminate the big black hole, right? If I give money to a university, where does it go? This is all about, I know exactly who it's going to help. I know exactly what types of programs it's going to help. So that's part of our deal with the university. Yeah. You know, I'll be the first to say that this is simple, but it's what it accomplishes that we get so inspired about. And I'm a big believer in simple elegance. And since they're here, I just want to point out Matt, my co-founder, and Tim, who is my hero, he's our Ruby on Rails developer, are the guys who built this. You might notice that there's not this complicated login process or anything else. You just take an action and we log you in. So when you share on Facebook, boom, we've captured your social graph. If you then went and shared a project, if you went to LinkedIn and connected on LinkedIn as well, on the back end, we're building this profile. So the sexy thing for the enterprise sale, and really where we're going, is that we'll have more information on universities' donors than they do, and that's really what they're gonna be paying us for. Sure, let me make a really important distinction, right? We're not about investing in projects, we're about making a gift to an educational process. So when you think of a business plan competition, right, that maybe the top 10% of those students that win those awards end up with an entrepreneurship education, what happens to everyone else? So the most important question that we asked ourselves when we thought about how do students get access to this platform is, how can they get access to it when they need help, not just when they know how to do it all for themselves? So all of these projects are either course embedded, program embedded, or a part of a student organization, so that they have people they can go to who will help them and give them, you know, support in how to present themselves, how to handle feedback, how to go out and get mentorships, all that good stuff. We're an education funding platform. Does that help to answer the question? Yeah. There's that part of you that says, hey, I wish a student could just throw a project up here, right? But the universities are putting their brand behind it. And because it's a tax-deductible donation, they're required by law to report on where those dollars were spent. So we need to find this kind of collective hybrid between enabling students to have a voice in their education, but also making sure the university's concerns were taken care of.
So you just mentioned that the university is required to reporting that use of funds.
Right.
Are you guys helping them with that on the back end?
Right. We build all kinds of tracking on, you know, where the money came from, who it went to, as of course, you know, analytics on, you know, who's a promoter, who's a networker. We're trying to create donor profiles so they know kind of how to pull someone in to volunteer more heavily. You know what's really cool about this is you tend to think of this as like, oh, I'm going to give a bunch of $25 gifts and eventually it adds up. But high net worth individuals actually are really attracted to this. And one of the big wins for the University of Delaware is they gave a small gift to a student and then came in and talked about making a major gift to the program. So sometimes people talk about cannibalization, aren't you taking money from the university? But it's sort of, it's a halo effect. The university wins on the sum total. Let me tell you why I'm so passionate about this, why I work 20 hours a day on it, and I'd work 22 if I could. Generation Y has got this amazing new thing going on. Any one of these projects, if you talk to these students, they want to build cool things, but they also want to make a difference. They're into fashion, they're into art, they're integrated, and universities don't know what to do with them. What we are is the first scalable system of project-based learning. So as cool as it is to fund a student's project, you know what's cooler? It's to see all of their peers go, I could do that. When we interviewed students, 3% of students had projects they wanted money for. Like, you know, we all know what they're like, right? They wanted to make a business when they were 10. And then there's half the students just don't care. They're there to study, get drunk, have the college experience. But the other half, and this is the half that we believe we see ourselves as like a mutagen of the college experience. This is the next evolution of the college experience, and here's why. Because if you'll take 2 minutes with those students, they'll tell you, I don't really have a project. But if you just take a little time to ask them, well, what are you interested in? What are you into? Have you ever had an idea? Have you ever thought of something that you think would be kind of cool to build? They go, oh yeah, that would be cool. They just don't know how to ask for help. And that's really what this is about. It's about lowering the barrier, bringing people to them, making it easy to start having those conversations. I mean, any student, when you talk to them, right, they're going to say, how do I find mentors? We're baking that in to the process. Here's how. When you talk with people who want to use social media, students who are trying to build their personal brand, what do I talk about? They have a baked-in conversation. So our vision as a startup, what we believe in is that every student, when they graduate, here's a statistic that should blow your mind. 85% of students, when they graduate, move home, and they do not get a job in the career that they got a degree in. 85%. It's broken. So our view is, this is a way that when a student graduates, if they're not offered a job, they know how to go make one. An artist can be an entrepreneur. A scientist can be an entrepreneur. It's about knowing how to involve other people in the things that you're passionate about and give them a way to help you, even if it's not money, you know? Learn how to like use those social networks. Cool, that's all I've got.
So how can the Philly Tech community help you out?
Temple is looking at bringing us in. Drexel, we've talked with Wharton. They need to hear from you guys. If you believe in this and you think this is something you would use, support, promote, contribute to in any way, let them know because they will respond to you. They want to do this. Every university we've talked to has said, this is really cool, but you know, there's a lot of politics. Well, the way to flip the game on politics for them and make it easy is if they're hearing from their community, this is something we'd like to see happen. So number one, please do. But the second is, I've got students who I'm trying to take care of right now. Go on the site. You know, if you see them doing something cool or if it's in your area of expertise or you think you can help them out in some way, please do contact me. For you students who have businesses, I love mentoring. I will hook you up with anyone that I possibly can. You know, tell us what your needs are and we will help you find your way.
Awesome. Give you guys a round of applause.